I've seen a few familiar faces from September. Gig we've done for Pete in Preston last year. Seen a few strange faces I haven't seen before. Anyway, we're the Doyle family. My name's Simon. Next to me, we've got Margaret on the fiddle. Then we've got Joe and Mikey on the pipes. We've got Winnie on the tenor banjo. And we've got Bridget on the button accordion, or the box, as we call it. Delighted to be here again. Well, first time here, but second time for Pete to get us on board. I was just looking at the drawing of the caravan, Pete, and you've got the window in the door. I don't think you had it the last time, did you?
No.
It's an improvement. Just a quick rundown on the back, rundown on myself and my family, and we generate from Irish travellers. My dad is from the town of Longford, in County Longford, in Southern Ireland. My mum is from Kildare, also in Southern Ireland as well. They came over here in the late 50s, 57, 58, back and forward since travelling around, and that's it. I got started in music first due to my father. He used to mix with one of the great travelling pipers, Felix Doran. He was also had a famous brother called Johnny Doran, played the pipes as well. And they used to tour all around England and Ireland as well, playing concerts, playing at horse fairs, busking, and in pubs, ceilidh bands and what have you. But that's how my dad got to know Felix, and I suppose he started me off first with the tin whistle and got me onto the pipes. And I passed down to the next generation, which is my family. We've actually got 10 kids, but I won't get into it. I'll just put it this way, I wasn't playing the pipes, so I'm back playing the pipes now. I've got 10 kids, 6 girls and 4 boys. I've got another 2 lads who play the tin whistle, and 2 small girls who play the fiddle as well. The set of tunes we played was the Kesh jig, and don't know what the last 2 was called. I'll think of them in a few minutes. So, what were they called? Donnybrook Fair was the second one. And Buttermilk Mary. See, it's just great when the kids can just step in and help kind of help pops out of, out of a sticky situation. But, what are we playing on? 2. Right, we're going to play a real set. First thing is Slide I Made. I got that tune from one of my dad's recordings of old Felix Doran, God rest his soul, that he used to play. Then we'll play The Drunken Landlady afterwards, and then a favourite of travelling musicians, a lot of people as well, Rackish Paddy, is a famous tune as well. So we'll give them a blast.
Thank you.
mouth to blow a bit of air, just raising the bellows. I've probably half of you is probably looking or wondering what the instruments I'm playing. They're actually Irish pipes. Well, there's various names for them: Ellen pipes, elbow pipes. They're basically a seven-reeded bamboo reed instrument, and you've got four double-sided reeds that's in them. They're very temperamental, the tuning. You know, if a room is kind of hot, they'll go too sharp, and then they're hard to keep in tune with other instruments. If the temperature goes down, if it gets too cold, they go flat. So it's hard to bring them up and to sharpen them up in tune. The intake of air isn't through the bellows. You use your elbow to suck the air in, sends it in the pipe across into the bag, squeeze the bag, and you've got a sound into the chanter. Then you switch on the drones. Then you've also got the regulators, which you can use for an accompaniment. So sometimes when they're behaving themselves, they sound all right. When they don't, they sound like a pack of cats crying. So, that's my excuse anyway, so pipers have different excuses. Right, I'll try slow air next. This piece of music it goes quite a way back in my family. My dad played it before me, and he'd often tell me stories where they'd be camped on the side of the road years ago back in Ireland, and that time, I think you'd be even lucky if you had a radio. There wasn't, no TV. Not for the boys and girls on the side of the road anyway. It's just campfire, an old wattle tent, a barrel top wagon if you're lucky, or a side lace car. Basically a flat with four wheels. You'd have to make a shelter tent. You drop it over the side of the car and make your bed underneath it. My dad was often telling me that there were hard days on the road, but he'd often say to me as well, if he had them back again, he wouldn't think twice, he'd be straight back. But anyway, I'd get back to that, there's to be around the fire at the end of the evening. It could be four or five families along the lane, and in good weather and hard weather, there's no such thing like me and my family now. In the good weather, we'll go out in the caravan, and in the bad weather, we'll come back into the house. So they didn't have the luxuries that we have now. But going back to the story, there'd be all camps on the side of the lane, and those times there was no help from anyone. There's no help for anyone, for travellers, especially back in Ireland. If you had food, I'm not ashamed to say it, they'd have to go out and beg for a sup of milk, or a small can of milk. Well, they wouldn't go to the can, they just go to a cup, a tin cup. I mean, if you go to the local farmhouse, if you've got a sup of milk, nothing like, have you got half a pound of sugar or 2 pounds of sugar? Have you got a small, two spoons of sugar you can spare for me today, or a bit of flour? But that's where all travellers came from, just a quick version, it came from the side of the road. There's lots of travellers now that's rich people and well off, but that's where we all came from. Once the men and women came back from out doing begging that day, or going off doing the tinsmithing, or selling horse hair, collecting it, or selling even saddles, harnesses, there was always ways for to try and earn a living. But when things was getting hard, they'd have to resort to begging. But anyway, if one family came back and they had more that day, they'd share out with all the four or five other families that was on the side of the road, and they'd all have the tea and what have you outside the fire. But anyway, that's then they'd finish the food, and then to start with the stories of the day, of of what happened, or maybe they carry on then with tales of what happened years and years before their time. Then obviously songs, and then if they were lucky enough to play an instrument, they'd take out maybe a fiddle or pipes or banjo, and they'd sit down and they'd enjoy the night. It's not like now, you know, you watch telly in your EastEnders or Carnation Street, and then, you know, I try and stop that as much as I can in our house, because it just takes up too much time. Or the phones, you know, steam coming off the two thumbs from the kids here, you know, texting. But, you know, at the evening time, we try and sit down and have a few tunes. But that was the way it was years ago on the side of the road for a lot of travellers. And they pass away the time singing and playing the music. But I'll try an old piece of an air now. It's called Eamon and Nick. Into another old tune called The Lark in the Morning. Philip Stone used to be, and Johnny used to play this years ago, a lot around the fairs, back in Ireland and over in this country. Then we'll go into Roll Finbar Fury and a family tune called The Maids of Monte Cisco. Still out of breath, I don't know why I'm out of breath. I'm not even blown into these things. These are all doing all the work here. I don't think I'm too fit. I'm going to try. Lasso Traveling People set. Played this last September when we were in Preston, and this one really hits home because it's the first tune of the Lasso Traveling People is. I actually got the air from Pekka Dunne himself, from the song that he used to sing. but I turned it into, just speed it up tempo and turned it into a jig. So we'll do that's called Last of the Traveling People. Then we're going to an old favourite of some of my uncles and aunts years ago. I used to play on the instruments called the Tenpenny Bit. Then we're going to another one after that called The Rakes of Kildare. Stage here because we actually drove up from Kent today. And so a place called Rainham, just staying in my cousin's yard it's a bit of a long story. My dad passed away in October and That was hard enough. But then my sister passed away in January, in the middle of January. She suffered long-term illness, but she only found out recently. But just to get us out from the house. Usually we wait for the better weather to come in, but it was out February, and we just pulled down south for a change. And but anyway, how long did we drive? I think it was 6.5 hours drive up, a couple of stops in between. You know what kids are like. It's just like a film, you know, we've been watching there a while ago. Are we there yet? Are we there yet? Are we there yet, Dad? So, but anyway, we made it up and heading back down to Manchester tonight. Staying with friends, and I think we've got a bit of a house concert tomorrow. But anyway, glad to be up, glad to be back up here, and well, for Pete to ask us up, you know, fair play to him, it's a lovely venue. Great audience, what more could you ask for? Have we got time for more, Pete?
Yeah.
Alright.
Yeah.
Right. Come on, help Daddy out. Right, well, we'll play a set of tunes. One is called The Green Meadows. Another one is called Craig's Pipes. And another one is called The Woman of the House. Mostly, well, everyone plays them, but, you know, they're mostly called Travellers tunes. Well, there's kind of a bit of a thing they're called a Travellers repertoire. You know, a lot of the settled musicians think that a Travellers repertoire is what? 12 tunes. I won't go into the thousands and how many I know, but we'll just stick to the Travellers repertoire for this evening. Keep everyone happy, yeah? Thank you.
Simon Doyle Band.